This may look like the scene from a horror movie, but these pig hearts are just byproducts from the local butcher, and they're being put to good use by UW-Madison researchers studying heart valve disease.
Our goal is to better understand how heart valve disease happens, as well as to make models of that disease in the lab, and potentially use those models to then test potential anti-disease treatments.
When blood gets pumped through the body, you want to make sure that it has constant forward motion. But in heart valve disease, those valves tend to get stiffer or thicker so that they don't open all the way and they don't close all the way. It's harder for your heart to pump blood forward, and you also get blood that moves backward.
Research in the Masters Lab focuses on understanding how statin drugs such as Lipitor affect the heart valve, and they also investigate gender differences pertaining to this disease.
We do know from clinical results and clinician observations that men present with the disease more than women. Now, whether or not that means they get the disease more or they're more affected by the disease or more symptomatic is unclear. So my project has been focused on elaborating on this phenomenon. I'm very excited and nervous about what could come from this research and how this could change the way we treat patients or the way we approach disease management.
Professor Masters originally intended to study how heart valve cells interact with biomaterials, but a simple realization led to her current innovative work.
One day I had that aha moment, realizing that we should really embrace what we do well and capitalize upon that. And what we do well is make diseased valves or diseased valve cells. One of the impacts I hope this research will have, particularly in the next couple years or a decade, is to better understand those sex or gender-related differences in valve disease.